All right, so last episode we just took care of Edna's malevolent crucible that was upstairs here. I took the liberty of running all the way back to the junction, and I think we're going to continue south. Why not? This is one of the previous save points we found. Let's see where this takes me to. Hello. Border Patrol Captain, if you're over your head and can't get back home, we can escort you back to town. That's part of the Border Patrol's job description, after all. Okay. More civilians, don't tell me you're headed for the Tower of Sacrifices. Just take a word to the wise, you'd be really better off forgetting that particular tradition of yours. I'm not trying to sacrifice people, I thought I'd just take a look. If I click on you guys or something, can I teleport back to town? Also, there's one horse that's not attached to the wagon. That must be the leader's horse or something. So, this apparently leads to the Tower of Sacrifices we heard about. Oh, Shrine of the Wind Trial. Right here. I just wandered directly into it. I wonder what was in the other direction. Oh well. Why don't we get started? one episode buffer between shrines.
Whoa! Check out how high that tower goes.
It's quite old, even for a ruin. I'd wager it's from before the era of Asgard.
Figures. This is where the Trial of Wind is located. The wind definitely feels different here.
Yeah.
Huh? That's a person! Lukeheim Yerlin!
Don't let your guard down. Something's coming.
Huh?
Doulahan, a headless warrior who brings death.
And he's not alone.
That's...
Zavid! Planning to kill again, are you?
Naturally. Didn't I tell you? My way is to put the Hellions back in hell.
What was that?
Now get out of my way.
I'm not moving. I won't let you do it.
Sorey, the Hellion!
Hold it. How do you intend to kill the Hellions?
Introduce me to your pretty young lady friends and maybe I'll tell you.
Don't screw with me!
Well, well, Mr. Sheperd. Looks like you've had a nice influx of eye candy. Your pure and virtuous act even charmed our feisty Edna.
I'll make your eye into candy. This guy's a Seraph?
You certainly haven't changed.
If that's the case, then you know what I'm about to do next. Don't you, Edna?
Wait, what?
You're going to fight us? What's the point?
I don't need you lot butting in every single time. I don't waste my bullets. Time for Professor Zavid to give you a lesson in ass-whooping.
We can quell the Hellions without you having to kill them. Please, listen!
That ain't the point, Sorey. If someone gets in the way of me doing my thing... use this to solve the problem. That's how I roll!
Hey, Zavid, been a while. Level 40. I'm sorry, I just got it. I had to be amused by the fact that the place where it normally shows the monster type just says, person. That caught me off guard a little bit. Alright, so Zavid, I'm going to want to avoid using wind attacks and earth attacks, so I should really just be Mikleo, basically. I'll be honest, maybe it's because we met him so early in the game and it slipped my mind. I totally thought Zavid was human. I didn't realize that he was a Seraphim.
Zavid, listen to me!
Not this time, pal! Save it!
Maybe I just forgot. I should really check. Have I unlocked a better heal by now? Purity heal. Moderate amount of hit points. There we go. And it removes poison and paralysis. It definitely takes longer to cast, though. Oh, that's a big heal, though.
What the hell is that power of his?
Does it come from that thing he was using earlier?
Still no clue, huh? Figures. Focus!
Oopsie. Oh no, they took out Sorey while I was about to finish healing him. Oh well. Time to go make a mess. He doesn't have that many hit points, so if we just do this a few times, he'll be in trouble. There we go. Uh-oh. That hurt a little bit. How you feeling about that, buddy? Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Really don't want him doing that to us. It's really a bad fit for me. I'm way out of range. Why am I doing that?
I shouldn't meld off if I'm not gonna fight for real.
Then let's stop this already.
As if. The fun's only started. Arrow. Break on through.
Pierce the skies.
Arrows for you. Chicks
dig. Oh, he. What? How do you interrupt that? I clearly already released the volley. That's not how arrows work. There we go.
I guess I screwed up.
Is it over? He's not moving. Maybe we overdid it, but it's not like he gave us a choice.
Can't listen to any more of this. All this talk makes me sound like I lost this one. Sheesh, settle down. I don't plan on wasting any more energy.
Hey, didn't you have a Hellion you wanted to kill?
If you guys can't quell it, then yeah.
Thanks.
Wait, how are you able to kill Hellions without the help of the Armatus?
Hey, you became Lailah's sublord, right? Shouldn't that make it so you don't have to kill anyone? Making him disappear should be plenty for you.
I don't need your lectures.
Whoa, easy. This is a tool that fires energy. This thing gives me the power to stand against malevolence. At the cost of my regular self.
Zavid, what are you?
Can we talk about this some other time, your Sheperdness? If we do it now, I suspect we'll just wind up locking horns again.
When are we ever going to have a chance to talk?
I don't think I'll ever get that guy.
He's a pretty complicated guy, all right. But I don't think I quite hate him.
He's certainly fascinating.
But hey, Dezel, what were you so mad about?
Dunno.
Oh, come on! Don't be like that! Tell me!
Cut it out!
All right, let's do what we came here to do.
Yeah. I'm definitely concerned about the person who fell and that Hellion that ran up the tower. Let's get climbing.
Oh, hello, right.
That was a difficult battle.
Guess they're still doing sacrifices.
I'm alive? Then I'm not even worthy to be a sacrifice to the Earth Spirits. Not even worthy of their salvation.
This guy threw himself off?
There's a tradition of human sacrifice around here. The tower must be a convenient spot for it.
Ridiculous. What a twisted religion.
There's no meaning in self-destruction. The Seraphim do not wish for such things.
But I'm absolutely positive that I saw the messenger of the gods. I knew then with great certainty that I was being summoned.
You saw it?
In rare cases, extreme spiritual experiences can open one's eyes to the world.
Looks like his are closed back up, though.
What you saw brings only disaster, to humans and Seraphim alike.
Right. If we hadn't saved you, never mind salvation, you would have given strength to a great evil.
Who are you?
I'm Sorey.
Say hello to the Sheperd and his posse. Hey, thanks to us, you didn't go splat even a little bit. What more proof do you need?
I think he's still in shock.
Let's just leave him alone. He's not related to our goal here.
So what's the plan?
I can try to convince him, I can show him proof, or I can leave him to proceed onward. I feel like just leaving him might be problematic. Showing him proof could be handy, because he could actually see that we're legit and maybe he'd listen to us over what his crazy religion stuff going on, but also it might be going too far. And he might flip out.
Really?
In Yuland!
Wow, mean. Not that I mind.
Now don't do anything foolish again!
Let's go.
The Roland's Frontier Patrol is just a stone's throw from here. They can guide people back to town. Why not take them up on it?
Jesus, I didn't know we were gonna, like, look like we're attacking him. Yeah, we freaked him out. Oh well, that happened. I did not know we were gonna basically attack him and freak him out. That was not the explanation I was given as far as showing proof of the Sheperd's power.
Man, Zavid sure is hard to grasp.
Yeah, he's a real joker for a Seraph.
It's nearly impossible to read his words or actions.
Lailah, tell us what you know about him.
I don't know about that.
Zavid, the Hellion Hunter. Quite the hot topic lately. His purpose seems to be fighting the Hellions. But who really knows?
Edna, you knew him, didn't you?
Kinda. He comes by Rayfalk every once in a while. Not sure why, though.
So in the end, we only know that he's still a mysterious Seraph.
By the way, Dezel, you and Zavid have a really similar fighting style. I wonder if that's some sort of clue as to...
The hell should I know? My skills are what I've honed for myself. That's all.
Okay.
Damn. Why does he get to me like that?
Because you probably have something to do with each other. You both win Seraphim, and you both use whips as weapons. That's noteworthy in its own level. It is, like, definitely quiet here. But yeah, I figured showing a proof of power, because Sorey is, like, a nice guy, generally. I figured he would, like, levitate a rock or something.
It's all crumbled.
Not a problem for us.
But... it's so high up. If we got up there and then got stuck, getting back down would be even worse.
I'll say.
And if that Hellion were to attack us on those skinny steps with no room to maneuver...
You just want to see the towers inside, you big ruins nerd. Let's go through the entrance like normal folk.
I was figuring, like, you know, parlor tricks, not make horrible things shoot out of the ground all around him like he's going to die in a few seconds. That's a little excessive. Figured I'd check. So is there no way to get up here at all? Figured I might as well check, at least. Yep, it's all collapsed. Oh well. I don't know if I agree with their saying. They said that it'd be hard to get back down. Can't we just armatize?
I've prepared some gel.
And use similar powers that we used to save that guy just to get down on ourselves? It seems like we'd be able to do that. Ah well. Fourth and final question mark temple? Oh wait, no, there's a fifth temple, isn't there? I think they said there was a fifth temple. Hello, freaky Drake. What does this place look like? Big circular room. I wonder if it's going to be a bunch of plain-looking floors.
What an odd ruin.
Definitely feels like the place for a trial.
This is supposed to be a trial? Pathetic.
Oh, you changed floors using pads. Is there anything over there? Just a big circular room. Interesting. What is wind weak against? Fire, maybe? That was weird. That was a weird moment. Alright, I'm just going to move on from that one. Whoa. Totally thought it was a teleporter, not an elevator. Okay. Definitely going to do a lot of teleporting around here. It's a cool looking place, by the way. Looks very El Shaddai. If anyone remembers that game, no one really played it. Little bottle here. Hello, friend. You're weak against physical. Alright, well, I can't. That's not one of the moves I can use on you, I don't think. When I'm doing that initial attack.
No use to. A refined martial artist, Hellion. Watch it carefully.
Kinda hard to dodge when they're so close. How's this?
That's what the physical attacks are for. Make a big old mess of them. If I keep us healthy, I don't have to worry about downtime between fights. Which keeps us moving at a nice little clip. Pew! Alright, so just a bunch of random platforms with kung fu tigers on them. Interesting. It's interesting because these things are structured for grinding, basically. Run through this room, fight all these guys. But the game kind of feels like it disincentivizes grinding if it apparently scales to your level anyway.
Guess there's no one but the Sheperd who can get past this.
It's probably the weird majesty of the tower that's made it an object of people's worship.
Mix that with the tradition of sacrifices, and you get folks flinging themselves from the top.
Even though not a soul really wants that for anyone.
How'd the guy get up there, by the way? Is what I'm wondering. Because, like, we can't get up there unless we teleport a lot, because the stairs are broken. Did the stairs break, like, 5 minutes ago? Or did that guy... How'd that guy get up there? I'm not sure how that works. Is there an item over... Yeah, there is. What are you? Look at you. Didn't really mean to go past her. Phew. Focus, God. Oh, looks like I've burned them by doing the opening that way because they're weak to fire. Okay. Strong against earth and wind.
Nice! A moving statue!
It's just an imitation. But its attacks are the real deal.
Perfect flame
surround! She's relatively scary now as a caster. Just a lot of rapidly casted crazy fire spells just going everywhere. I haven't done a crucible as her though, so I actually don't have a good idea of what her spells are.
You're pretty mature, Rose.
Coming from you, I'm not sure how to take that.
What now, Edna?
And you're such a kid.
There we go. Yeah, I don't know Layla's spells too well. Definitely get a little bit more accustomed to some of them when you start doing a crucible and you're stuck as just them. Although, I don't know how I'd ever fully process the spells for six characters at once for a real-time game. Maybe if you play enough times. I know that when I was like 20 episodes in, I was already getting comments from people saying that they were in their third playthrough, and I'm like, holy crap, guys. It's okay, the game will still be there when you wake up next week. It's okay. Hello, you're weak against fire. I'll handle this, Rose. Burn! And then everyone exploded. The end. I might just be casting all of her spells. Don't judge me.
That was pretty good, Shorty.
Being big is for losers. Big losers.
I think we're firmly out of dialogue. Hello. What are you? You look important. Oh. Those control the doors. Alright. Makes sense. Everything is Wind Seraphim based. There's just enough platforms around, though, that I'm totally going to lose track of where I've been and where I haven't been. So if there's a temple where I'm going to miss out on treasure chests, it's probably going to be this one. Let's see. This one loops around a bit, but there's also something over there. Oh, hello. Oh, did it go and open the other one instead? No, it opened this one. Nope. Yeah, it didn't open this one. There's one over there. Can I reach that one? Wait. What did I open a second ago? It might have been a door I hadn't noticed yet. Or maybe it was over here. Well, I mean, that's also one I wouldn't have noticed already. Hello. And now I think we open... Yeah, that's the exit. Alright. Oh, shit. Please, Edna. Hello, friend. You're weak against physical. Alright. I think if we just combo them enough, we'll be fine.
Is it over? I'm kinda tired.
Oh, you'll survive. You don't even have to walk. Sorey does it all for you. So, are there any more doors in my... I think we've cleared it. Yeah, solving puzzles halfway on accident.
That spinny mist thing sure gets the job done.
It's the wind trial, after all.
That's roughly what you should expect. Sure. Hello? I'm just gonna hit all of these whenever I see them and just assume that they're all good until I'm proven otherwise. Like most puzzle games, I wouldn't be surprised if at some point one of them's hooked up to multiple doors and you have to deal with the, like, if you press this, it opens this one but closes that one and the ramifications thereof. Maybe. That said, I don't think this game really goes for actual puzzles necessarily. Judging by what we've seen so far. Oh no, is that one broken?
Looks like there's something nearby.
Ruined windmill of Hyana.
We're finally as high up as that weird-looking thing.
What could it be? It sure doesn't look like anything made by human hands.
Yeah. With that there, it starts to make sense how people came to worship this tower the way they do.
I doubt it. Ordinary humans could never make it up this high inside. It has to be the tower's outward appearance that caused it.
Who cares? The point is, we're nearly at the end, right?
I don't know about that.
I think we're maybe about halfway up.
Seriously?
You out of steam?
No, I'll be fine. Thanks.
I wasn't really worried or anything.
Fail.
Fail what?
Hey, Meebo, show an example.
What? Why me? And wait, example of what?
Lailah.
Huh? Well, it's okay if you get lost. Just sit back and leave everything to the official Dazzle Windrush. That distant cliff can be underfoot in the blink of an eye with the official Dazzle Windrush. But wait, that's not all. Buy now and get this handy bonus Dazzle absolutely free. A 500 gold value, free for this limited time offer.
Hey, only 500 gold? I mean, wait, What the hell are you talking about?
That. You should have done that. Saved everyone all the trouble.
I don't... What?
Dazzle's such a patient playmate. Look at him, putting up with all of Edna's nonsense.
Hey, as long as everyone's having fun.
Trust me, Dazzle. I know how you feel.
Ah, Jesus.
We're here to purify you, but it'll still hurt.
Jesus Christ, Edna. We're here to purify you, but it'll still hurt. I'm pretty sure I'm casting something that isn't even reaching my opponent, but I also can't see. That was a weird moment. That was an experience. I'm not even entirely sure what just happened in that dialogue, but I'm happy I found it. Get your own Dazzle absolutely free. Limited time purchase.
That spinning mist thing really does get the job done.
It's the wind trial after all.
Okay guys, we've been over this, it's okay. So I saw the exit, but obviously I want to figure out how to get to the chests and stuff. This looks like it's going to be a pretty brief trial. Seems noteworthy that the two trials furthest away have like extra story attached to them as far as I can tell. What's this one do? Maybe it builds a bridge? Oh, no. Alright. Trying to think of the fire. I guess the fire trial had that particularly cool moment with the burning blade and being told to burn one of your friends, basically. That was a cool little story moment of like, what the hell are you talking about? What's going on here? And I guess the earth one had the one about the orphan children or something that were dying. They got killed and turned into monsters. So I guess they all kind of have their own story. It's just slightly more caught off guard when the story in these last two is actually story that has to do with stuff outside of the temple itself, or Sheperd becoming more powerful or proving himself to be a good hero. Is the moments of like, oh yeah, here's a primary villain reveal, and here's a guy that seems pretty he's a wind seraphim, and we've encountered like no characters like him. He's got the character design you would expect from a party member, basically. Huh. In fact, it feels a lot like when we were meeting Rose early on.
It totally gets the job done, that spinny mist thing.
It's the wind trial, after all.
Dazzle, you realize she's not going to stop unless you say something else, right?
Oh my god, it was a joke? That was a joke? I didn't even catch on to that. That whole it's spinny mist thing getting the job done thing. Like, that was... She was saying it over and over again on purpose to get a reaction. Oh. So what's strong against you? Bubble. I don't know. Nope. Resistance is... her weakness is physical. Wanted to use earth and... wanted to use fire and... wind against them, basically. All right.
It may be small for a dragon, but it's still a dragon.
If this is small, I'd hate to see a big one.
If we can't beat this, we'll never defeat a real dragon.
Okay, this one's getting a little close to me. Let's focus on them a little bit. Oh shit, that's an AoE. Alright, I'll just run up to him then. Hello, friend. I'm gonna explode on you. Yay. I'm pretty sure he got out of range anyway. Oh well.
Nice job, Mikleo!
You've been slacking off, haven't you?
Nice to talk to you too, Mikleo. Glad we could have you along. That genuinely surprised me though. I did not really... I'm amused by the fact that she was saying it over and over again as a joke. Just constantly toying with Dazzle. Edna's easily the most enjoyable character just because she's so awful. But not in an evil way, but just like relentlessly messing with everybody. The dry humor. Particularly the part where she has a thing going on where she wants it. She has a big emphasis on things being funny, but specifically doesn't actually care if anyone else gets the joke. It's just something amuses her, and that's the whole purpose. Oh shit. What do I do from here? Um Huh. That's a conundrum. So, I must want to move one of these doors. Let's see, is the camera going to be facing the same way? That one. I want to move that door down. Okay. That puzzle I was talking about seems to have happened. Which one do you touch? That one? There we go. So we've locked the chests back up after looting them. And now we should be able to move forward. Oh man, this could involve a lot of backtracking and awkward running around. If it gets particularly intense. Let's see how it goes. Do I have to move all of them? Or is there going to be another switch around here? Oh, that's
Lailah. Never have I seen anything get the job done more than that spinny mist thing.
It spins the mist, after all.
Whoa, Dazzle! You actually put some effort into it. Good job! Don't think about it too much. Just go with the flow.
Ow. Rude. Oh, weakness to fire. I know a girl.
He's a powerful hellion with strong wind mana.
What is up with all these friggin' wind monsters?
Other than its arts, it can produce tornadoes. Be careful.
Ow, ow, ow. Y'all are being rude. You're gonna have to pay. Damn. Ow. Stop it. Leave me alone. Holy crap. Holy crap. There's so many attacks happening. And they all interrupt, as far as I can tell. Damn. Calm your tits. There we go. Made a dent in their overall forces. That'll be easier. There we go. Nice try. You mostly just replenished my supplies. There we go. That's a low grade. Oh, someone got KO'd. And nothing was really worth any points aside from that. Okay. Nothing back there. Hello? I was gonna say, we were like halfway through the top. If we were halfway through, that was surprisingly fast. But if there's puzzles in this part, then that would make more sense. Another chest over there. I mean, I've got it, right? Hello, burn.
Ready for this?
Burn. Focus. Burn.
So, what kind of arts do I have? I don't think I've mapped them for a while, actually. Let's see. Imbuement, refresh. I have a higher healing spell. Pyrogenic ring, blitz bomb. A lot of these are higher seraphic arts, so pyrogenic goes to blitz bomb, goes to flare vortex. That sounds fun. Photon blaze, burning strikes, the higher that. Spirit cage deals non-elemental damage to a single enemy, having a high chance of causing paralysis. It steals focus. Let's try burning strike, spirit cage, photon blaze. Sure. Oops, I mixed up which one I thought was which. Photon Blaze, Burning Strike, yeah. I prioritize forward and backwards because they're easy to remember, mostly. What do you look like? Oh my goodness. That was dramatic. Oh Jesus. That's a lot of particles on the screen at once. Yep, that's the type of thing that makes a video take longer to render. A bunch of complicated particle effects on the screen. How do you feel about more tornado?
Looks like we win.
That got dramatic. 7.23 for defeating a foe with a mystic. Yeah, duh. Obviously, I don't know why I checked why the score was high when he clearly did a mystic art during that fight. What's going on with the music right now? Huh. That was a weird, like, club-sounding thing going on in the background that was not what I would expect from an RPG necessarily. There's a big guy over there. This door needs to be closed if I want to proceed, though. Yeah, there's nothing over here but a chest. Old divide. Bye, buddy. Pume. Alright, we need to close the door that's right next to here to move forward. This door needs to close. Is it nearby? I don't necessarily know which things were which. Okay, that's how we got in. Must be the one over here. Must be the one over here. Boop. Oh, there's a lot of lifts around here. So is it you? That's not the one I was going for, so let's let that one be for now. Can you skip? Nah. I wish you could skip that. These types of... Yeah, that's something that JRPGs always have had some trouble with. Oh no, that's not the right one either. Oh well, I can close it anyway because it's over a chest I don't care about. It's not the right one, right? I needed the one that was over... Yeah, I need to open this one right here. Maybe if I use the other elevator, it'll give me access to something I need. But yeah, one thing that JRPGs don't get right quite is that they give you these puzzles, but you still have to play as a character that really slowly wanders around this really weirdly large temple, and then a slow animation plays every time you interact with the things. So it makes something that should be a relatively simple puzzle take longer just because it's really spread out and moves slowly. Alright, something moving down will probably help me. Oh, walking into walls. What do you do? Moved something down. Okay. Take a look around. Oh, you can't teleport that distance? Okay. Well, we have a chest over here, if nothing else, and that'll open something over there. Maybe that's what moves the thing I'm trying to move so hard. Oh, put it back. You can keep that to yourself. I'm probably not going to make this... Oh, I made it. Was that the one I wanted? Maybe? It was by a giant hole. That was probably the lift I was looking for. Now for the backtracking. Pachoom. Hey, bye. Have a nice time. See you later. Shwoop. Alright, we're probably done with that one. A bunch of stuff's closed over there. Oh crap, did I lock? Oh, hello. Chest. Oh, that's a bunch of gald. Did I lock myself in? Or do... Maybe the teleport can still make me... Yeah, I think I can still reach where I'm trying to go. Right, yep. We're good. And that thing's down. So I should be able to move forward now. Here we go. Up, save point. I believe that means we're done here. I already went over there. Alright, I believe we just finished the Wind Temple. Now it's time for the usual boss fight, I'm sure. There we go. Yeah, at least it doesn't teleport you back to the front of the dungeon like a certain other one did.
Welcome, young Sheperd.
It has been some time, Sheperd Wardell.
Indeed it has, Lailah.
Is this Seraph a Sheperd?
I was, several hundred years ago.
So just like Exio, huh?
Enough chit-chat. This isn't what we're here for.
I assumed as much. Young Seraph of Wind.
Dezel.
Dezel, this tower in and of itself constitutes the trial. In other words, once you reach its top, you have cleared it. The rest depends on how I feel about you then.
Sounds like there's a catch.
I bet it has something to do with the sacrifices and the Hellion we met at the entrance.
A sharp observation indeed. Now then, head on up to the platform at the top. There shall I see your mettle for myself, O young Sheperd and his friends.
This is probably where I find out that one human wasn't even a human, and that was part of the test or something.
It's
hello.
Here.
I have Edna using the ability that helps me spot these little guys, but so far I don't think it's actually going to make that big of a difference. Bonus against snakes. No particular preference on who to give it to, I guess. There we go. We found another one. I wonder how many I've missed so far. I want to be surprised if there's ramifications for what I did there when I misinterpreted what Sorey was going to do when I talked about showing the way of the Seraphim. I thought we'd just float something and look, be like, see, power. But he's like, I'm going to intimidate you like a monster. What's wrong with me? I'm suddenly a sociopath. You know, Sorey, the guy that's always friendly all the time. Like, why'd you do that, Sorey? That was maybe not the best response, but okay. Alright, this is sufficiently dramatic looking. It actually looks like a Halo level, of all things. Okay. I'm here. Love me. So two of them are empty, but one of them has a person on it. Possibly getting ready to sacrifice themselves. How are they getting up here? They must not be real, right? Because how would they get up here? The stairs are broken. And they can't teleport.
Someone's there.
Where's that headless hellion?
Hang on! Get away from me!
Why are you looking to make a sacrifice of yourself?
I have to die. There's no other way. I killed someone. The man who was exploiting my family. For that reason, people who didn't even know us would curse at our family, throw rocks at us. I only did what I did to preserve my family's happiness, but it's brought nothing but more pain. The legends say that if I throw myself from here as a sacrifice to the gods, then I might have a chance of absolving myself and of restoring my honor. It is my only hope for salvation. If the prospect of life promises nothing but suffering, then better I die.
Enough. Let her go, Sorey.
What?
She regrets dirtying her hands for the sake of her family. Seeking restoration of her honor. All she wants is someone's approval. She doesn't even think that she's to blame.
What's gotten into you, Dezel?
Nothing.
A Hellion's domain!
Rose! Mikleo! Stop that headless bastard!
Okay,
got it!
So no need for me this time?
Let's leave it to them, Edna.
Dessel?
You want to die? Then why are you hanging on so tight?
Eyes on the prize, you headless freak!
There are plenty of times when I've wondered if I truly did the right thing. We all have. That feeling of loneliness, it can drive you crazy. But the idea that sacrificing yourself will erase your sins, it's a fallacy. Killing yourself means nothing to the Seraphim.
But I...
You worked so hard to protect your family. Do you want to leave them all alone? For the sake of a sacrifice that has no meaning at all?
I don't want to die.
Keep struggling. That's the fate of all with blood on their hands.
I know I sound pretentious, but my friends tell me I need to stop trying to bear everything by myself too. We all need our families. If you work together, I'm sure you'll find some way out.
I'll try.
but your trial is not over.
That's right!
We still gotta stop him!
Here we go. I was honestly convinced that, I thought that Dezel might actually, like, sacrifice himself and maybe even die to this demon that is apparently the harbinger of death in order to save somebody. Just because I'm getting really convinced, like, Zavid has all the character design elements of a main character for a JRPG, which basically splits him between, he's either going to be a villain or a party member by the standards of this game so far. Because there hasn't been anyone else, basically, so far. Everyone else is really plain or boring when they're not one of those two things. And he doesn't seem like he's going to be a villain, so why does he have the same power and use the same weapon type as Dezel? Almost as if he's just going to replace Dezel in the party? It's happened once already. Alright, so he's weak against fire. Hello. Got a few abilities I can use on you. I gotta stop using that tornado thing so much because it's like a close range ability. Yeah, that seems to be plenty helpful. Uh-oh. This works better when he's alive. But for the moment, I think I can milk a few attacks for a little longer, though, before I armatize. There we go. Is he not taking damage at all anymore? I think he is. I might have overused that spell. Armored Undead Dullahan. Do I have anti-armored or undead skills? Nope. Now it's working again, but it's really weak. Ow. Alright. You made me mad now. Hello, friend. Watch out. Try to heal up a little bit. Oh, that was not very effective. There we go. Oopsie. This definitely seems a little bit durable, doesn't he? Get out of there. He's mad at you. Make a mess. What's he doing? Oh, was that supposed to be a banishing blast? Let's take a look here. Oopsie. Armatized fire, seraphic arts, mystic art flamberge. Oh, BG4 or higher. I was confused. I was like, did I just do a mystic art or not?
Now you've done it.
Oop. Why'd you have to take out Rose like that? Mikleo, you might want to combine. Alright, I'll try a stall. Oh, we're good. Oh, look, people leveling up. Most of us.
So this is what became of all those sacrifices.
A warped idol, born of a warped religion.
You're gonna be all right. Can you stand up?
Are you the Sheperd?
I'm called Sorey.
Then are the gods, I mean, are the Seraphim with you?
Yes, a wind seraph accompanying me named Dezel is the one that saved your life.
Hey, keep me out of this.
Oh, thank you so much, Seraph Dezel. Really, truly, thank you. I promise that I will live bravely from now on. I'll look in my soul and find a way to believe in myself.
Aw, he's embarrassed.
We still have a bit more business here. Think you can get back down by yourself?
Yes, I'll be fine. I'll have someone from the Frontier Patrol take me back to town.
Yeah, good idea.
Somehow it all worked out.
Seriously, how are people traversing this tower on their own?
Could this be some sort of training?
I don't understand how they're doing that. Holy crap, we're high up, by the way. They just didn't load the world below us anymore. It's just a floating texture. So it looks like we're literally impossibly high up. But yeah, is there a separate staircase somewhere else that is still working? They just don't let me access? There must be, because that's two humans that have made it up here. I'm going to be so pleased with myself if I called the whole Dezel Zavid thing. But I'm not going to look up anything about it. No spoilers, guys. We'll just wait and see.
You have shown me not only your strength, but your spirit and bonds as well. You are more than qualified to receive the spiritual power of wind.
You speak of spirit? Bonds?
Surely you have noticed, Dezel, that which is attached to your being at this very moment. It is not something that you should deny. You felt the voices of your companions and acted of your own will without any need for words.
Are we done with this yet? Get it over with.
Do you have something against developing true friendships? Why?
There's something very important that I have to do. You should have picked up on that by now.
And it is with true friendship that many obstacles may be surmounted. That you have reached this shrine, overcome the trial, and now stand here at this very altar serves as testament of that fact. Now then, let us offer a prayer. To the young Wind Seraph, and also to the young Sheperd. What awaits you on the path ahead, none can say. Heartbreak, redemption, endless possibilities. Never lose the guiding light that will lead you safely to the end of your journey.
Yes.
Light, huh?
So then, Sheperd Sorey, may the light shine always on your journey.
Thank you, Wardell.
How you feeling? Okay?
Yeah. I just wanted to thank you.
Huh?
Dezel, you mustn't push yourself too hard.
Hey, at least you got to do something out there.
There's no need to stay here. Let's go.
Are you all right? The power isn't affecting you, is it?
I'm fine, but thanks for worrying about me. We've obtained all four spiritual powers. Think we're ready for Heldolf?
Well...
No way to tell until we try, right?
Yeah, but first, we gotta track him down.
How? He hasn't exactly been mailing us postcards.
We know where he was. Why not start there? The battlefield. Works for me.
Oh wow, we're getting ready to go after Heldolf, huh? Well, I still have that other zone to explore, though. Let's see. How does one... Oh no. Do I have to leave this place the slow way by going all the way through that every single floor? Oh no, no, we're fine. We have a save point to use. That'll work. That'll do nicely.
We found quite a few discovery points.
Exploring ruins is all well and good, but you have to be careful when getting sidetracked like that.
Really?
If you don't look properly at where you're going, you might turn the corner and bump into someone.
That's when you gotta use that fancy footwork of yours. Take a quick back step.
Actually, Rose, it would be most appropriate to sidestep in that situation.
Yeah, yeah. And then if you could coordinate it with other battle actions, then you could easily increase the stun rate.
That'd be a pretty sad scenario for whoever you bump into. We've collected quite a few anomalous orbs.
You mean those orbs you get from mutant Hellions?
If you possess these orbs, you will be able to manifest powers beyond your ability. But there's also the risk of turning into a horrible monster.
Then wouldn't it be better to throw them away or break them?
It's fine for now since I've sealed its powers, but it's nevertheless something that can have a baleful effect depending on how it's used. And moreover, breaking them will cause malevolence to spread over the entire area.
So in conclusion, it's a good idea to pick these up as we go to avoid further problems, right?
Yes. But mutant Hellions are incredibly strong. If you ever find yourself in a tight spot, remember that there's no shame in escaping.
Got it.
Alright, so I warped back outside into the gorge where we were before. So I believe we're done there, but I'm probably, if I remember when I come back to this game next time, I think I'm going to go up to this north corner, because there's something else up here I haven't explored yet. At the very least, if nothing else, it's probably a dungeon with a boss fight that could level us up and get us another, maybe another iris gem or something, little pieces of story and stuff like that. Gonna go ahead and take a break here, guys. Thanks for watching, like always. I'll see you next time.